see you.
Well, you are a little... You are a little droopy.
Whose fault is that?
It's mine, but we'll fix you up. I keep saying that. We gotta make an appointment and get it done. Ready?
I need to schedule time with you. You're that busy?
Yes. Hold my hand.
Okay.
Okay. We are ready to make baby owls. So this is probably a level 2 project, like you've done something. But it is definitely So if you have another project under your belt, that would be good. But it's definitely still a very good beginner project. So you could start here, but there are slightly simpler projects. What makes this so fun and great is that the armature is super simple. It's one wire is the main part of the armature. And then it does get a little complicated when we get to the toes, but we're going to go through it step by step. Very simple armature. And then the kit has so many different colors and textures in it, and you can make all different kind of shapes of owl faces. The kit makes two baby owls, and I mean, you can make them, you know, with the tufts, like their ears. You can make, this is more like a, is this a snow owl or a barn owl? I'm spacing out.
Barn owl.
with the heart shaped face. And I mean, I just was having fun sketching all kinds of different faces, and they're all made the same way. It just kind of depends on how you tweak it. So if you are just getting started, at the minimum, you need the Stabit Wabbit felting surface, a felting surface. This is the one that we sell and prefer, and felting needles. If you want to go a step further, then I would recommend the Zoli tool. That's kind of like the Zoli tool and the Pink Pen tool are sort of the next things that I would invest in if you're getting started. We make a lot of shapes on this, so it just really simplifies the felting process to make the shape and stab it on. Makes everything really consistent. For this project, we're also going to use the digit widget. It helps keep toes and fingers really consistent. So, but you can definitely fold your armature even if you don't have this. This is just something that that I came up with to help streamline that process. And then we're also going to use Swax. This is another Serafina original product that I like to use on the beak and toes, and it does two things. It helps when you are felting little fingers and toes, it helps the wool stick where it's too thin to get a needle, where it's hard to get a needle in. And then it also can be used on top of the wool, unlike beeswax alone, which we also sell as a little helper on the little fingers. But unlike beeswax, it can also be used on top of the wool to like smooth it and make it look like a different texture, and it shines. So for beaks, hooves, toes, it's great for that. So we have supply pack, we have our tools, we have our gusto.
Yes. It's going to be a hoot.
It's going to be a hoot.
Yeah.
Who knew?
Ooh,
I knew. All right. We ready to get started?
Yep.
All right. Owl, you ready?
That's a stretch.
I am ready.
This is not news that it's a stretch.
I am ready. I have my Swax is warming, so hopefully it will be ready.
Good to know. Warm your Swax, people.
Warm your Swax. Especially as we film today, it's like 8 degrees outside, so. And I have my felting surface and needles and tools and my supply pack. And I'll show you what you have in here. It makes two owls. So you have a big bundle of
core. That's really the majority of the project. You have a variety of top coat colors. This black is in here too. Let me put that over here. So gray, Polworth, light Polworth, and this is called grits. And these are for all the shingling top coat of your owl. So there's enough in here that you can make a owl that's a majority of a light color, like a snow owl or a barn owl, or you could make an owl that's a darker color. I usually do white tummies. It's just the way I end up doing it, but it could be any coloring. And like I said, it makes two. Then we've got some white. This one. This is more of a creamy white. It's also a top coat with a nice long staple, so it'll work well for shingling. That will become apparent as we go on. A couple of different core wools, oatmeal and black. And that's for the legs, and the black is for the eyes. And then we have these are for the eyes. This is like tons. You could make like 20 owls with this golden colors. And then there's going to be, and this is going to be different from kit to kit. We're going to give you an assortment of locks. So some will be gray, some will be brown, some will be light, some will be long. These are really long. Some will be curly. And the idea with these is you could throw them in as details on around the face, or if you wanted to do this guy, I put some as his tail feathers. So, you know, when you get your kit, open it up, take a look, start to think about, you know, what these could go onto a wing, what locks you have and how you want to use them. Also, you will have some pipe cleaners. You will have some 26 gauge wire. And you'll have two 14 gauge wires. And each one of these makes an owl. Hold on, Milo, say something funny.
I got it. Wait, is this what you need?
I think it's out here.
Oh. We're all discombobulated.
Where is it? Oh, right in front of my face.
Say I'm something coming. Funny.
No pressure. Fill the gap.
Okay.
I don't have anything funny.
The 14 gauge wire makes the beak, the head, the body, and the legs. So we are going to find the center by bringing the ends together and then working towards the fold. And give that a pretty good pinch because that's going to be the end of the beak. My pile of wool over here is covering up my instructions. Okay, now you want to twist these evenly by putting equal pressure very gently. See how I'm not up here twisting real tight. I'm letting my fingers slide back so that I have nice big half inch twists. If you twist too tight, it eats up your wire, it fatigues your wire. All right, you want to go 6 inches. So the stabbet has 2 inch marks on it. The Zoli tool has 1 inch marks on it. So you could use either one. Just think this will be visually more clear for you. Okay. Okay. Now, this is going to be the head, the neck, the body, and the legs. So for the last twist, I do kind of go a little tighter just so I know, you know,
That is the definitive end to the twist. So you want to take about 3 inches for the head and make a little hook. And then the beak, you're going to stick out at about an inch, about 3/4 of an inch, at a 90 degree angle. And then you've got this hook. And then I'm going to take my pliers and pinch this pretty tight. And if I can, I'm going to give the beak just a little hook. Little kind of downwards bend. And then on your legs, you're going to create like a 1.5 inch backwards bend. So an inch and a half down from the end of the twist. And that's his hock. I always get these uneven. There we go. And then an inch and a half down from that, you're going to do another bend like this. And that should give you about an inch and a half left to work with. And what you want to do with that is create a loop that is going to be the base of the foot. Oh, you know what I would have done if I were smart? Is make this wire long enough that it makes that back toe when it comes back. We did that on something else. I think we did that on the big owl. And yes. That eliminates...
That's a big wire, though.
No.
These are dainty.
Yeah, well, all I mean is, and so maybe as when we pack this, since we haven't made the kits yet, we can do this. So this would be a change, but not a hard one. If we made this wire longer, see, this is good. You guys can see troubleshooting process. As it is now, I can make a loop for the foot, for the other wires to make all 4 toes. But if I make this wire a little bit longer, that toe's done. And then we only have to make 3 toes. So I think I'm going to do that.
So when the people are watching this tutorial.
Yes.
Using their kits.
Pause it. I'm going to cut this wire and do it right now.
Oh.
Okay.
Well, okay.
All right. Sometimes it takes me a minute to catch up to me. All right. We're going to go over this again because that's helpful. All right, so we're going to twist 6 inches, still going to twist the same amount.
So if somebody already started, they'd be fine.
They'd be fine because I caught myself. Okay, on that final twist, I'm going to get it a little tighter. Okay.
Same thing with the head and the nose.
Yeah. I'm going to get that beak tight with my pliers. I just bring them in, pinch it down a little, get a nice fold there, a nice tight twist. And then when you're working with this little area, you do need the pliers to get that hooked nose. Okay, inch and a half. Hock. Which is a backwards bend, and then inch and a half down to the foot. So just line these up. Okay, standing back up here. So yeah, these are his little legs. Now I can make this loop, and what I want basically is to make a triangle. So if you're looking down at the foot, here's my leg wire. Coming down. I'm going to make a triangle that goes like this.
Whoa, I am zooming all over.
Oh, sorry.
Trying, well, it's pencil in the sun.
Yeah, hard to see.
Okay, hang on, there we are.
But these will be rounded because it's wire. Okay, so I've got this triangle. This wire comes back and makes the back toe. The white wire will make 3 more toes. So that's how that's going to work. Yeah, sorry, I probably had a lot of adjusting to do. So I'm going to work with about little half-inch folds from, we're going to call this the ankle, where the leg meets the foot. So about 1/2 inch out, I bend it, about a half inch out from that, I bend it. And that leaves me that little open triangle. I'm going to bend this foot the same way. Now, I'm left-handed. So if you're right-handed, you're probably holding, using the pliers in your right hand and holding the armature here. So I'm bending my wires to the left. It might be more comfortable for you to bend your wires to the right. But I'm going to bend them in the same direction, even though it's not symmetrical to the animal, because when I wrap these toes, that's going to make my life easier. Okay. Now, I want to use, on the digit widget, I'm going to use the fourth step. So this is the first step, second, third, fourth. So I want this back toe to be about that, as long, as tall as that fourth step. So that means I'm only going to fold over this very last little bit of it. And that way it'll be the same length as my other toes. So now you have a back toe already. So this next part is a little tricky for those who haven't done this before, but after this and wrapping the toes, the project becomes a little easier. Unfortunately, sometimes we just have to start with these sort of harder things. Okay. So I'm going to, how did I do this? I'm going to start just below the hock and wrap down with my 26 gauge wire. And then I'm going to keep wrapping down until I get to this inside toe, which would be our big toe, basically. Okay. To use the digit widget, it's a good idea to flatten out this front of your triangle. What that looks like is, if you were to cut your fingers off, it's nice and flat. You know what I mean? It's like, and this is, then we can rest the digit widget against that and build the fingers off of that. So I'm going to use the fourth step, and by leaving this open, this back open, I can just bring my wire right through there. So now I've wrapped around three times. They're all the same. And I'm going to, before I slide the digit widget out, I'm going to come around and wrap around the foot one time. We're either getting a package or people are picking up packages.
To all the dogs out there who are listening along, there's your excitement.
Yep. Okay, so now I can close that foot up and take this wire up the leg. And that wire really holds that foot closed. And then I've got to twist each toe nice and tight so that it stays put. And if I want to, I can pinch it with the pliers. So this is good. We've got our back toe. We've got three toes. Piece of cake. I want to wrap this wire. Oh, sorry. My. Somebody here. No. Okay. I want to wrap this wire the same direction that I wrapped the other wire down, so they're not crossing each other, but they're moving in the same spiral. And I'm going to come all the way back up the leg. This way we don't have to use any pipe cleaner on the leg. And it's going to create the tail, a little tail support. So when I do my other leg, these two wires will come back and make the tail. Okay, let's go through this again. And I'm going to work in the same direction that I worked on this leg. So in this leg, I was kind of working from the outside of the foot, but since I'm holding everything the same, I'm going to be working on the inside of the foot versus trying to come out here and do it right-handed. These are little things that as you keep felting, you'll figure out what's comfortable for you. So I come down the leg to the ankle. I need to do another wrap in here. I'm going to actually feed it through because I do a better job at not making it crimp because you're kind of trying to wrap into a tight place here. So now I'm coming off that. I'm going to flatten this out so my digit widget sits right up against it. Get this out of the way. So we want to do three toes. One, two, three. Now, to keep everything in place, I'm going to come around this wire. I could go around one full time even. And then I'm going to close this up, this foot up. Really pull that foot closed and start coming up the leg. Now I can slide this out. And then twist these toes to keep them in place. We're so serious today, Mila. We're right into work. If you call this work. We are lucky to call this work, really.
This is true.
Okay. Coming up the leg, it's a little awkward. Now, I can twist these two wires together and make a little tail feather.
It's pretty tricky there.
And always I want to just bend this back. I'm leaving it about 2 inches, I guess. Doesn't need a lot. Now, owls, they have this. Their toes can do some crazy things. You see them sometimes on a tree with their two front toes hooked on the tree and their two back ones going the other way. This outside toe can go either way. Just so you know. Little owl info. And then I think you have four pipe cleaners, but you probably really only need two. We just wanted to give you some extra in case you needed it. So we're gonna come up the body here. It's easier for me to wrap up the body to the nose than it is for me to start on the nose and go down the body. Milo, you're getting a call from Bill.
What? Oh my. He does not know we are very busy.
And then I can use the pipe cleaner. They have a really pointy end to the beak. So I can use the pipe cleaner to, I'm going to fold it out just a little further than the wire rather than folding it right against the wire. Because then I can just take some of that off. I'm going to fold it out maybe like a quarter or eighth of an inch out. And then just make sure this wire goes back in the same direction. That way, when I wrap my wool around that, it's going to really tighten down on that point. Can you see that? Like how that makes a better point than...
Yes,
keep it. So. It'll be thick.
Extra beaky.
Extra beaky. So that's your armature. And from here, we start wrapping wool. So my swax is nice and hot. I like to use in your kit, one of your cores will be this gray. It'll be a nice long, long piece. So, I like to use this for the legs and toes. It just works really easily. You could, you know, on this one I went over with the oatmeal, but the gray feet, it's just a nice neutral, kind of no matter which direction you go with the coloring of your owl. You could have gray legs. You could put a lot of fuzzy, you know, oatmeal on there to make, or even off-white to make it look like he's got furry legs. Nice feathered legs, rather. This guy has skinny gray legs. So it kind of just depends on the look you're going for. So I pulled off about a 6-inch piece. Depending on how fluffy your particular piece of core is, you're going to split it into halves or quarters. 6 inches, just so you know, is whenever I talk about the length of a piece, it's not including the fuzz. So it's an approximation. This is 6 inches from here to here. So don't worry too much about the exact length, because it's not exact thing. So I think I'll split this in half. No, I'm going to split it into quarters. So let me do that again on this piece just to show you. When you want to split something lengthwise, you want to start in the middle. And that gives you just a nice opening, and then the fiber will follow from there. If you start at the top and try to go down, it just tends to get real fuzzy and not as, you want a nice defined piece. And as I work, it's going to stretch out. So now it's already 8 inches. So that's just what happens. We just got to start somewhere. So first thing I'm going to do is wrap down the legs. I'm going around the body just to get it anchored. This doesn't have to be super tight and skinny, but you do want to follow the direction that your wire was going. So as I get to the bottom here, I have enough to do a toe. But I think what I'll do is just do one toe at a time for you guys to see the amount that you need to use. So I'm going to pull my extra off and just finish this out around the foot. I don't want to put too much around the foot because I don't want it to get all big and bulky there. So make sure you try to get rid of that extra wool. Now to do each toe, I want to use a piece that's real thin and about 3 inches long. Okay. And what I'll do is just anchor it around the foot somehow. Pick a toe. I'm going to do this one. Again, their toes might have some feathers on them, so it doesn't have to be super duper tight and skinny. You want it to be tight in the sense that it's well done, but it doesn't have to be ultra skinny. I'm just squeezing that little tip of the toe. Now when I get to this point where there's about a 1/2 inch of wire left, I'm going to either put some swax or beeswax. I've got swax here. And then wrap the wool into that. So I'm just kind of pressing it in. And then I'm going to go back. So I want my little skinny piece to be long enough to go out and back. That way you can anchor at the base of the foot before you head out and after you get back. So with the swax and with this little bit, you shouldn't have to stab, but if you feel like you need to stab, you can stab right in the middle of that loop. Let's do another one. Nice, consistent, skinny piece. I'm going to take this little fringe and just anchor around the foot. It started to let go there, so I got to start over. I know. Jeez.
It's flying.
I'm going to put these aside because we don't need them. Okay. I was trying to anchor with too wispy of a piece. All right. I'm going to head towards the end of the toe. Keeping it tight and consistent. And then
the head of the armature keeps wanting to get in the way.
Okay, I gotta tip it a different direction. Putting swax on the wire. How's that?
Better, I think.
Okay. And then I'm pressing the wool. This is why we do more than one. Because we have
owl heads in the way.
Limited video skills. And then I'm taking this fuzz back. And even though it's getting really thin, I just keep wrapping. Just keep that little fuzz going until it's totally gone. Okay, before I do another toe, I want to wrap this other side, this other leg, so that you can see that again. I'm making sure. Okay, if you're just starting needle felting, when you wrap, everyone, in my experience, gets a nicer wrap when they wrap away from themselves. So if you find yourself sitting there trying to wrap towards yourself, try to change that habit right now, because as you go away from yourself, you can see what you're doing better. You can just, it just naturally gives you that pull. As you go away, it's a little harder to pull towards yourself, and you'll get a nicer wrap. It's a good habit. So I'm gonna take off the extra, just finish this around the foot. Oh, you know what my one problem is? With this wire, doesn't have anything on it. We'll see how it goes. Let's do one of these back toes and see how it goes. Usually, when I have aluminum wire, I have a pipe cleaner or
something
on it so that it's not slippery. So I'm just going to try it and see how it goes. Maybe with the swax, it won't be that big of a deal. So I'm heading out. Might use a little extra swax. Oh, geez. I don't know. I'm like a klutz today. I think that was a needle, which isn't good. Oh. I'll find it. All right, and then I'm going to press this into the swax. And come back. I think it's worth it. I think it's worth the time it saves. It's a little awkward getting that toe back there. With the 26 gauge wire. So it's a little trade off, but I think that's gonna be okay. All right, I'm gonna do. Do I have time for one more toe?
Sure.
All right, let's do one more together.
You have all the time you want.
So, real thin, about little skinny 3-inch piece. And we'll finish this. We'll do this last one over here.
Why did the owl invite his friends over?
Because he had some extra food. That's why I invite my friends over. Or I've got something new I want to show off. I don't know why.
He did not want to be owl by himself.
Oh gosh, there I go again, getting ready to flick another one. Owl.
It's your owl. Sleeve. Your little sleeve cuff is catching stuff.
I'll have to remember that one. I'll have to forget that one. Okay. Yeah, my sleeve. It's my big sleeve.
That one almost has a little claw going.
Yeah, that's what we're going to do next.
Cool.
So exciting. All right, wrap all your toes.
Fun.
Okay. We're getting into some swaxing, so I wanted to show a couple of things. This is how the swax comes, and
very crinkly.
It is really crinkly.
Sounds like a snack.
It's so annoying. Don't take this to the movie theater. Okay, so Talbot says that you can hit it against a corner and it'll, like, we have it perforated into these little squares because you don't want to, you know, melt the whole thing. You want to melt a little bit at a time. So I'm going to try that. Can you see right here? I'm sorry, I have to adjust again.
We're just taking everyone for a ride.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay, so I'm going to try to hit it where this line is on this corner. Last time I did it too hard. Oh, okay. Okay, well, that worked. Because if you don't, you can still break it, but it's just like a little gummy. So it's funny how it cracks and is gummy at the same time. So then you would take this and put it on your... I'm using a mug warmer I got at the Goodwill. And we have... You can use it. It's this kind of... It dries to... I mean, it heats up to sort of a transparent color. But it does have a little yellow tone to it. We sell pigments. So I've used the black pigment in this little tray. And this is really fun. So we're going to give our owl toenails.
Ooh.
Claws. So to do that, your little... Oh, we also have these rubber-tipped tools. They're called color shapers, and we sell them as a set. And these are real helpful for putting the swax on. So it'll get a little bit of swax on the tip. You just take it off, and then you can reuse it. Just put it back to melt. So what I want to do is scoop up some swax and paint his little toenails. About a quarter of an inch. All the way around. So I'm just painting the whole end. And I want to give it a minute. Not quite a minute. 15 seconds. So while I'm waiting 15 seconds, I'm going to do another one. And the reason I want to wait 15 seconds is because if you touch it when it's too hot, it's going to stick to your fingers. But if you give it just that amount of time, it'll be cool enough that it won't stick to your fingers, it sticks to itself. And you could shape it into a little sharp claw. Now I can do this one because enough time has passed. And then they'll shine up too after they dry the rest of the way. Sorry, it's a little hard to see, but I just want to make sure that I go all the way around. And then I'll show you on the back one. The back one's a little weird because it's thicker because we folded that metal wire instead of the white wire. All right, so I have this one to do. So that gives him little talons. Now, I have also swaxed the beak. We haven't wrapped the beak yet. But this guy I did with clear swax because I didn't want him to have a black beak. So I'm not going to do that right now. We might do it a little later after I decide what kind of beak I want him to have.